Hello and welcome to my current top 6 solo games in under 6 minutes. Number 6 we have Lord of the Rings The Living Card Game. This game has been ranked for quite some time now and it has many expansions and adventure decks been released. Since 2011 there's been lots of stuff added. I've personally had a love-hate relationship with this game. This is the third time I've bought it and this time I'm hopeful of keeping it, maybe playing it to completion. It's a difficult game to play with many phases and steps to each round. There is a helpful gamer guide on BGG to help you out and Rodney over at Watch It Played made a good video a few years ago. The deck building side of this game still feels a little bit lacking to me, but I'll continue to persevere. Dawn of the Zed's 3rd edition. Farming Dell is in trouble again, and for the solo player, the task of saving the town is quite a difficult one. I backed a Kickstarter for this game and it hasn't disappointed. The component quality and sheer bulk of stuff you get in the box makes me a happy gamer. This game is tough. In solo play, you choose 4 heroes and play through the game controlling all of them. However, only one of the heroes gets a player action. I've played a few games solo and things get brutal pretty quickly. I don't get this to the table as often as I should, but just by making this video I realise how gorgeous the game components are. The vinyl stock is lovely and it's really nice to hold in the hands. Setup time is around 10 minutes. Once you have referred to the relevant manual, found the decks, sorted the zombie markers, found your hero tokens and so on. There are a lot of rules in the game that you can get wrong, so if you choose to try this one solo, prepare to spend some time on the BGG forums. If you're after a tough, solo gaming experience with some light fluff and backstory, take a look at Dawn of the Zed's 3rd edition. Pandemic the Cure by Z-Man Games. I've lost track of how many Pandemic the Cure games I've played solo, but rest assured I've probably lost most of them. Solo or with friends. This is a light to medium game with tons of dice to throw about. It's really fun because you're throwing tons of dice. Make no mistake, this game is tough and regularly defeats players, some may even say annoyingly so. The fact that dice are involved is the reason you'll lose often. The game components are great, the dice quality is good and the character dice are moulded to a high standard with no issues. This isn't Pandemic however, the dice really do change the game massively. It's very nice to play solo. Setup is very quick, a bag of dice, the game discs, the hero cards and you're good to go. Play is fairly simple as well. Each round you spread disease by rolling the brightly coloured disease dice and seeing what number comes up. If you have more than 3 dice the same colour on a disc, a new one is added, you have an outbreak. Too many outbreaks, you lose. You clear the infections by rolling syringes and sample jars and you can move around the board by rolling ships or planes. It's about £22, absolute bargain, try it. Descent 2nd Edition, with app support. Descent 2nd Edition, another old one. This game has been out for a few years, and with FFG's usual attention to expansions and add-ons. Although when first released I was very interested in this game, the lack of a solo variant put me off. I know there are some fan-made solo variants on BGG, but I didn't get on with those very well. Then, FFG pulled it out of the bag and released the Road to Legend app. The app takes on the role of the Overlord and makes this game a solo gamer's dream. You still need to know the rules, you still struggle with the various nuances and interpretation of the cards and the rules. Head over to BGG forums, rest assured someone would have had your problem before and you'll find the answers there. Tons of stuff in the box, high quality miniatures, adds to the atmosphere of the game, it's all good. Painting the miniatures isn't difficult, you can make it as difficult as you like, but it doesn't take too long to paint the minis. I think these two that you're seeing now took me about 2-3 hours to paint. The campaign changes in the actual game itself, so the app takes control of your campaign, so the campaign book that you get in your box you can just put to the side and not use. If FFG continue to make this sort of stuff, I'll be expanding my collection. Elder Sign, dice chucking again. Yep, I do like throwing dice in my solo games. Elder Sign, this is one of the first games I purchased way back when I first started playing games with a little more depth. Again, this is the second time I've owned this game. I have the Unseen Forces expansion, which adds things like blessed and cursed cards. The game can be set up in around 5-10 minutes. Grab a handful of dice, prepare to take on the world of Lovecraft. Because you're throwing dice, there is randomness, which you can only try to plan for with good use of clues and special abilities. Tabletop with Will Wheaton did a very good playthrough of this game. If you want to learn the rules or see it in action, I suggest you head over there and watch that. It's really, really helpful. probably not much of a surprise for a solo gamer that in September 2016, my current number one solo game is Mansions of Madness 2nd Ed. FFG has slightly changed their stance here by releasing a game that requires an app to play it. For a solo gamer like me, that's fine, it ticks all the boxes and I'm a happy camper. However, some gamers think it's the end of days and we're all doomed as cardboard tabletop games morph into electronic driven hybrids. I would be concerned if a higher percentage of games being released were completely app dependent, but they're not. It's because Mansions of Madness is a big box release, there are some people causing a hoo-ha and think it's going to be the worst thing ever. If you're a solo gamer, check out my playthrough, see how the game runs with the app and the mistakes I make when playing it. It's quite a hefty price tag, it's worth it. If you're into Lovecraft, you enjoy dungeon house crawlers, buy it. You won't regret it. It's atmospheric, enjoyable, and quite tough. Solo games on the horizon. There's Masmora Dungeons of Arcadia should be coming soon. Looks great. There's some playthroughs on YouTube already. Check it out. I'm looking forward to that one. Xenoshift Dreadmire is a standalone box from Call Me or Not. I'm a Kickstarter backer. This game is due to land shortly. From what I can tell, it's hard as nails and it'll drive you mad. Brilliant. Arkham Horror the Card Game. I have this game on pre-order, no idea when it'll land in the UK, but hopefully soon. I saw the previews at Gen Con and that's it, I'm all in. This looks like it could be the game to make Lord of the Rings fall off my list again. It looks like a refined version of Lord of the Rings and I'm really looking forward to it. Can't wait. So I have listed my current top 6 games. What are yours? What have you got arriving soon? Comment below, let me know. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Happy gaming.